All right, guys, today we're going to be working on door speakers. Right now we got these small Panasonics in here, and they've been in here for years. And I think I can upgrade these just a tad. So, I've got these Kenwoods that I'm going to be putting in here, and this big sub box that's going behind the seat. But I wanted to get a baseline for you guys. So, this is gonna be a big upgrade. Don't mind the stuff on my floor. That's all clean stuff from my woman's Sprite. I got these just in case this kit didn't come with it, but we'll find out. We'll find it along with you guys. I don't know if it's got it or not. I think it does though, because it shows it on the thing. And then this right here is gonna give me a lot more bass. So we're gonna get started by taking the door apart. Alright, next thing we're gonna do, turn your stereo off, disconnect your battery, or just do like I'm doing. Don't matter. But you're going to want to pop this off. It takes a screwdriver to pop this off. I had already, you know, almost popped off for you. This unscrews. Okay, now you're going to get a screwdriver. There's two screws under here. Right there. That you're going to want to get in. Get these two screws out. You can actually see them.
Yeah.
So get these two screws off. All right, this next part's gonna be a pain. But as you can see right there is a clip. You're gonna wanna take a pick and completely lose it. I found it was over in the weeds. I'm gonna put that somewhere safe. After that, this comes right off. All right. Next step, you can do this with or without the tool. I want to show you with the tool because it does help from breaking all the clips and stuff. What did I do with the tool? And me, every time I work on something, oh, there it is. This is a clip tool. It's great for newer vehicles and it's also great for these doors. It's the reason I've got it. I've got it for to work on anybody else's vehicle. But you're going to want to get in here and you see that clip. All you're going to do is put this in behind that clip. Make sure it's seated good and squeeze. And that pops it loose. Now, there's a bunch of these clips. You'll be able to see it when I get the door off. You can see these clips are really bad for breaking, and this really does help quite a bit from breaking these dead-end clips. Okay, but I'll show you the door once it gets off. Let me get all these clips out. When you get all the clips off, this lifts straight up and comes off. You gotta make sure that gets around that. So you're gonna have to like do it like this. It's gonna have to go up and then up. And even though I had the clip tool, as you can see, all the clips refused to come out. So all you gotta do, clips don't wanna come out like this one was too far in. Do it like that. Or get you a pair of pliers, flat nose, needle nose, they all work the same. Just grab the edge of it real tight and give it a swift jerk, and these pump right out. Oh, and of course I've already lost one. all those clips came out perfect. I just had trouble over here because it's hard to get my tool in here, but okay, that clip's broke. Good thing I got a surplus of Nissans. Come off. Will I replace this? Probably not. Am I going to start cussing in a minute? Probably. Will I do it with the camera on? No. Come on. Alright, I want to come back when I get this clip out. Good news, everyone. I found the clips. The door panel bent through heck and back. Still good, though. Okay, now these four screws. Where's my screwdrivers?
There it is.
If you don't talk to yourself while you're a mechanic, then you're not doing something right. Okay. Oh man, that heat feels good. Pretty sure I could have took this off with my toe. Faster. Why is this one just... Come on. Okay, now. Okay. No. Okay. I know this is not professional, this won't last long. There we go. Oh, someone was so professional. That's what I had in it. I'm going from 150 watts to 300 watts, so I'll get professional. Okay. Now, of course, I was hoping that it had the clips, which it doesn't. I don't know what that is. Oh, I know what that is. That's for my power mirrors. That's the thing me and Matt installed. Okay. It's this. Oh, whoever did this was professional. They used paper tape. All right, then. Let me get this mess sorted out. I'll be right back. Okay. So I figured out, these are actually clips, so that's really good. Let's do an unboxing. Brand new parts going into my old truck. Man, this must be a sin to most people. Watching my channel, then I probably know. Alright. Directions. I need those. Okay. Oh, yeah, these are nice. Ha 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 ha. Yes. Please. These are going to be some bad dads. Okay. So these. Oh man, I'm so happy with these. Let's see how these will fit. Oh, like a glove. It's worth. Even got screw holes. What kind of madness is this? Okay, I'm gonna screw this in. All right, got this in. I decided I'm not gonna put the cover on right now because it won't fit under the door panel. Maybe later on I'll cut the door panel out. But for right now, this is gonna cover it. I know it's a shame, but this is what I've got to work with right now, so But that's installed. I've already, you know, tested to make sure it's actually getting fire and stuff, so that's good. This is what I was talking about. Yeah, this is not, I can't right now. But, you know, maybe later on I can get that. Okay, now, get this back on. You can do it with the thing off, but it's fine. Get this, line your tabs up. Okay, what you're going to do, flip it over and bend the tabs down on this side, and I'll be back when that's fixed. All right, guys, got the door panel on. Now, it's just as simple as pushing these clips in. See them from the hole there? Push that one in, push that one in, make sure they're all flush. Go to this side, find your clip, push it in, find your clip. Push it in, find your clip. Make sure all those are in. Make sure it's, you know, good and secure. Okay. I'm gonna do the easy parts first. So grab that, screw that on. Grab this one, just put it over top of it. This fat side faces down, thin side faces up. That's in, that's secure. This will be a pain. And the only thing you gotta do for this one is put your screws through the holes and screw it in. And this one, I'll show you as soon as I get this one back on. I'm just going to put these screws in right fast. So, I used to hate this part more than anything until I learned the secret. You lose your clip, because that's what I've just done. It was just here. Okay, let me find this. Alright, let's try that again. First, you put this in here. Put your little dust cap over top of it. This little beauty ring, whatever you want to call it. You wiggle it back and forth and just... Ha ha! Now she's on. I used to have to... The way I used to do it is I'd put it on while it was on the truck. So much simpler this way. And it saves you losing a lot of clips. And I found it, I just dropped it on the ground. But yeah, this way it's a lot easier. So there's one door speaker. All right, got that door finished, got that door finished. Those speakers are installed. Next up is a subwoofer. And I got super glue all over my hands. And for some reason it turned white. But anyway, I want to show you what it sounds like now.
Because she looks like a total prostitute, okay?
A lot better than it was, and it's got a lot more volume now. So that's a lot better. So now all I gotta do is I'm gonna take this out. I've already got the wiring ran, so I'm just gonna use this wiring because the other one didn't come with the wiring, which is stupid, but you know, can't complain too much. I already had the wiring. It's right here, and I don't know how I'm gonna mount this. I'll figure that out too. Yeah. Guess let's see what we gotta do first. Down there so nothing gets lost. Okay, I know what I want to use you for. I gotta use, what is this, 20 amp. Okay, I'm gonna use that one because I took that one out. Okay, that, run that under the seat. Okay, this should be actually pretty simple. So I'm gonna start by unhooking this and getting everything ready. All right, I tested to see if that would fit in here, which it does. And I've already got the wire stripped. Don't mind that, there's extra wire and I don't feel like messing with it right now. It's cold. But got these. Now all I gotta do is solder these. But just to let you know, positive comes from battery to the red. Ground, you can ground this to the body, to the frame. You can ground this straight to the battery. I grounded it right here because this goes down and it's into the frame, so that's good. And then the blue wire is the blue wire that no one ever uses on the radio. I've already got all my wires ran. If you want to see where the video where I ran this, it's later on in the videos. So, yeah. All right, guys, so I cheated just a little bit. Went ahead and hooked it up. Had to run this wire back there for this. So I might mount that later on. For right now, it's just gonna ride there. I'm tired and cold. Got all this hooked up. Pretty basic. Gotta make sure it's hooked in. But yeah, that only hooks in one way. I got the blue run to red, black run to white, because you know these are not regular AV cables, but you know, the same thing. All I did is hook that in, the fuse is already in it. Close that. Okay, all I'm gonna do is pop the hood. There's some videos that can go way more in depth, but I'm cold and I know you all wanted to see some of the build. So, this wiring's a mess, don't mind it. It's not pretty, but it's fine. Ugh. Okay, push that in, close it up. There should be a 10 amp fuse, but I got the 20 amp for right now. I just wanted to test this. And all that fuse is for anyway, is if something shorts out right here. So something shorts out from here to in there, that'll pop. So. And then there's a fuse in here too. So it'll pop. Now, turn the key on. Okay, it turned on. All right, let me make sure this is turned down here. Because I'm going to have to adjust it. Because it didn't come pre-adjusted. But, it ain't that hard to adjust it. Just got to mess with that, and that box. But I'll get it. But I'll be right back. Set up. Got my tuning knob all ready to go. Wipe the grin off my face with a cement block. Oh, I'm so happy with that. But guys, I hope you enjoyed this as much as I did. Thank y'all for watching. And yee yee.